to update the Mr. Beast thumbnail, you're going to go to photopea.com. And once you land on photopea.com, you're going to click and select PSD Templates. You're then going to be on the menu. You could easily type Mr. or you could scroll down to go find the thumbnail. We are editing Mr. Beast thumbnail template. Shout out to Mohammed Noor, who has created this for us. Then you're going to click on photopea.com in order to start editing. Photopea works on layers as well as the tools that it has. So you're going to be using the tools to maneuver and navigate and make changes, as well as the layers to adjust. So I like to work strategically and starting from the bottom up. It just makes things better for me. The arrows have the layers that are pointing to the right, as well as the eye to hide them or show them. So that's how you navigate the layers. So if we're going to start with the background, we're going to click the drop down arrow so that we view what's on our background for us to manipulate. It's showing us the background, the sky, and we're going to either hide it or delete, which I'll show you a little bit later, so that it takes it away. And then we're going to click and drag our sky that we've downloaded from Canva, and we add it on there. And the sky is added. So how did I get the sky? I went to Canva. So let's quickly jump to Canva. I went to Canva, I searched for sky, and I downloaded the sky and jumped in on Photopea to edit it like that. So I'm going to click on the correct mark to make sure that the changes have taken. Scroll a little bit up, close the background, and then I'm going to drop the Lambo so that it opens the Lambo and the layers that are on the Lambo. Once you open your Lamborghini, you can hide the Lamborghini, or you could right click and you can delete that layer altogether if you don't want it. I prefer hiding it. Then I click and I drag my car that I've downloaded from Canva as well, or whichever element or image you want to use. I'm going to drag my car using my move tool and make it nice and big. And then I'm going to click the correct mark, and I'm going to control S to save the tool as a smart object. And then I'm going to close the Lamborghini layer, because then it would be replaced on my main page. The next thing that is on this layer, it is the arrow that you see that's pointing there. You see, when I use my move tool and I click and I hold the arrow, it starts moving around. So we're going to be spending a little bit more time on the arrow so that I can show you how it works. Even the money, you can click and you can move that. And when you click on the Lambo and arrow, it is also an image that you can tweak and adjust and make it your own, or delete and add your own arrow. It's up to you. What I do want to show you is you can manipulate the arrow by clicking on the transform controls. You're then able to move your mouse ever so slightly to show the back-to-back arrows, and then you can maneuver the arrow and point it to wherever you want it to point to. And if you want to move the arrow the other way around, you click and you hold the controls and you squeeze and you point it. I'm still holding my mouse so that it moves direction and it can point and change the way that it is pointing by me maneuvering it like that. The last thing I want to show you on this image is you're going to double click where it says arrow, and then it will give you a menu where you can adjust the arrow and how it looks like. So with the drop shadow is already ticked, you could add a stroke if you want over and above the stroke that's been created on this image. You could select and double click on stroke, you see, and then you click on fill color, and then you can choose a white fill color, and then you have that nice fill color and you can size it the way that you want, and you click on OK. And that takes care of the Lambo and the arrow. Next, we are going to work with Mr. Beast. So I'm going to open Mr. Beast, and his picture is over there. So you again hide Mr. Beast. Mr. Beast's there. Hide Mr. Beast, then you can add your own picture, and there's the guy that is shot. You can also now use your move tool to move him to wherever you want to move the dude. When we dragged him, he landed on the arrow and the Lambo. So you just click and hold and you drag him to Mr. Beast. And I'm using my move tool just to move things around. That takes care of Mr. Beast and I've replaced with my own. The last thing would be the text. You can double click on the text itself so that you can make changes. I want to write it's lost, and I'm gonna click the correct mark, have my text over there. I don't like the way the text look and I want to change it, so it's up to you. You could double click on the text itself, then you go to the fonts that are available and you can make changes to whichever font that you want, and then it's gonna be applied. If we don't like the color and we want to make adjustments, we're gonna right click on the T or the text itself, then we're gonna go to blending options. And on blending options, you can move the menu around to suit wherever you want it to sit. The first thing is the stroke. I don't like the black stroke. I double click on the stroke and I click on the color and I choose white because I like white. It looks much better in my opinion. And then it's changed. Then we're going to color overlay. We double click on color overlay and we click on color itself. I don't like the green. I want something nice and shocking, so I will go for pink or whichever color. Then you can move the color along so that it catches the eye. And once you're happy, you click on OK. And we click on OK. And you want to download, you're going to go File, Export as a PNG. And then you click on Save. If you want to learn more basics of Photopea, go watch this video that I've created. Thank you for joining me today. I will see you on the next video.